The season concluding PBA Dick Weber playoffs have been a microcosm of this year on the lanes. There have been upsets, routes, and just bad breaks.
It happens every time.
Plus, a near perfect performance.
That's nine.
Today, it's the live finale where weeks of play have whittled our field down to three. The Cinderella story, Randy Weiss.
That's right.
Favorite, Chris Barnes. And the wild card, Dick Allen.
Is that bringing it enough for you?
Who will finish the season on top of the bracket?
Yes!
Ago, we began with a field of 156. Today, it's down to three, and three matches later, we'll be left with one. It's Allen and Weiss, both from Columbia, South Carolina, and Team USA member Chris Barnes battling for the first ever Dick Weber PBA playoff crown. Thrilled you're with us this Sunday, Rob Stone and PBA Hall of Famer Randy Peterson with you. Interesting show we have lined up for you this Sunday. We're going to reflect back on some of the really memorable moments from the season, and there have been a lot. We're going to be battling those things that are being blown behind us, Vuvuzelas, for the next hour and a half, and we're going to determine a champion courtesy of a very interesting format today, Randy.
Totally unique format, Rob. Unlike anything the PBA Tour has ever seen in its history, we're going to have our three conference champions bowl one game. The low score will be eliminated. The top two will then advance, and the high game will be the number one seed. The championship match will consist of not one, but two games. And remember, this is not total pinfall. The player that wins two games will capture this championship. If they split the two games, this month-long championship will be decided by a sudden-death one-ball roll-off.
Now, let's meet our three finalists.
From Columbia, South Carolina, Randy Weiss.
Your South Region champion earned his ticket here the hard way. As a non-exempt bowler, he received no byes and no chance. But the 37-year-old persevered and now sits on the cusp of his first PBA title.
From Columbia, South Carolina, THB, Dick Allen.
He goes by the nickname THB, typical house bowler. But he's been anything but a house bowler here. Allen has dominated this tournament from day one as he looks to earn his third PBA crown.
From Double Oak, Texas, Chris Barnes.
This season, Barnes became just the sixth player in PBA history to win the Triple Crown when he claimed the world championship. Today, one of the game's all-time greats looks to claim his 14th career title.
Yes, yes, yes!
And Barnes will bat leadoff for us today in Indianapolis. Final event of this PBA season. That's how you start.
And Rob, watching all three finalists warming up, it looked like Randy Weiss had the best ball reaction. Chris Barnes' ball reaction looked a little bit suspect.
Dick Allen, the new father, has been on the tour since 1999. Allen with the strike. He hasn't won since late January in 2006, the Motel 6 Phoenix Classic, in which he defeated Hall of Famer Del Ballard Jr. Now here's Randy Weiss.
Again, the low score in this match eliminated.
Hook a lot. Bow down.
Just a little quick there. Ball pushes too long down the lane, leaving the 2-4-5. So we take a look at Chris Barnes' arsenal. He's going with a world beater, the strongest in terms of hook in his arsenal.
Back-to-back opening jacks for Barnes.
Okay, so remember that thing I was talking about? Barnes' reaction didn't look that great? Well, he figured it out.
He's very good at figuring things out on the lanes. Randy Weiss trying to clean things up, and he does.
I picked this guy to win this tournament when he made it to the regional finals.
Randy Weiss, the Cinderella story, and in the crowd there is one of Randy's friends. That's TJ Prozalanti, dressed up as Cinderella. He could not talk his buddy into dressing as Little Bo Peep, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately. Four pin left by Allen.
You see that back end reaction right in front of the head pin. Just a pinch high leaving the four pin, but boy, you said it, Rob. He totally dominated this event, and we're looking for Richie Allen to get off to a really quick start.
Randy Weiss in the second. Gets all 10 to drop there. He was 60th at the Pepsi Viper Championship, his best finish this season until this tournament. Allen on the left lane. Curls that one in for a spare.
Barnes told me before we went on the air that the left lane was a couple boards tighter. He's using two different bowling balls. He figured out a way to blend the left lane out in the first frame. Obviously, that shot was perfect. Let's see if he can follow it up with another strike and a three-bagger.
And Barnes with the early lead through two frames. Barnes has made at least one TV appearance in 12 straight seasons. A couple years ago, was voted the 26th greatest PBA player. And I think he kind of keeps climbing up that ladder.
He's been magnificent this year on TV. And, you know, his struggles on television have been well documented the last couple of seasons, not this season.
Dick Allen working off a spare in the second. Here he is on the right lane. In the third, gets all 10 to drop. Randy Weiss up now. Spare in the first, strike in the second. Here's his arsenal, Randy.
Going with a Nomad, which is kind of right in the middle of the arsenal in terms of hook potential. But remember, the first shot went light, 2-4-5. The second shot was a light mixer. Let's see if he stays with this choice of bowling ball.
Jerry.
Messenger just misses the 10.
And this is what happens from practice to the start when the lights go on. The low moves down the lane a little bit, and all of a sudden his down lane reaction is a bit too soft.
Barnes, his effort in the fourth. He has been perfect through three. If we were to label these three guys, he would be labeled as your favorite.
Without question, Rob.
That's an opening hand bone. And his son in attendance. There's Ryan shredding eardrums. Second spare in three frames there for Weiss.
Remember, it's the low game that's out. So no matter if Chris Barnes shoots 300, all that does is get him into the finals. It'll be decided between the other two players. But taking a look at Dick Allen's arsenal, going with a mission because, quite frankly, he's a man on a mission.
And a man dressed to impress today as well, working the all whites. Looks like a Navy week in New York City or San Diego.
This guy was so pumped up in practice, he was running them out. I mean, that's how fired up Dick Allen was getting ready for the start of this telecast.
He's got a lot of confidence in his game. His time here in Indianapolis with the Dick Weber PBA playoffs has really done a ton for his approach between the ears. I think also becoming a father has done a lot for him as well.
Give me 10 from Weiss.
There's that soft hand and nice rolling soft speed that gives Randy Weiss that great ball reaction down lane. It's exactly what he's looking for.
So Allen with strike spare through four.
Come on.
Barnes, perfect through four. He kicks off the fifth frame. Interesting to watch the pace of this match so far. Three guys, kind of a hectic speed it up, but when it comes to Barnes, it stops. It slows down, and he plays the tempo he wants to play.
Yeah, exactly. He's not going to change his rhythm or his pre-shot routine for anyone.
Strike on that right lane for Allen.
And there's the polar opposite. Richie Allen up immediately, boom, off and running to the foul line. And a nice result, mixing the rack up there. Strike, spare, strike, spare, strike for Dick Allen. No doubles yet. Randy Weiss can double up right here in the fifth. And that would put Dick Allen in the bottom of the pack.
Right of target and a tough lead for Weiss.
Jeez.
Again, this is his first live television appearance. Handled the lights very well through our tape shows leading up to our live presentation of the Dick Weber Playoffs Championship Sunday.
Well, no harm, no foul here if he can convert this washout.
Come on, baby.
Yeah! Now, the Bear Trusted Pain Relief Replay brought to you by the makers of Bear Aspirin. This one could have been painful for Randy Weiss, but the gentleman from Columbia, South Carolina steps up and textbook finish.
Yeah, and that's huge because that keeps him tied with Dick Allen. Just a great, great shot given the circumstances and the pressure.
A big conversion for Weiss. But early on, through five frames, it's been all Chris Barnes. Perfection through five. The conclusion of our three-way match one. When we return, one of these guys will see their season close next. Chris Barnes in early control, though. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, welcoming you back live to Indianapolis for the conclusion of the Lumber Liquidators' Dick Weber PBA Playoffs. Chris Barnes in early control, up by 40. Time now for the Lumber Liquidators' Know the Wood weekly segment with Randy.
The Dick Weber oil pattern is 39 feet in length and is a tapered oil pattern. What that means is lighter oil to the outside part of the lane, and as you move towards the center, you'll find more oil. Remember, the darker the blue, the heavier concentration of oil. This pattern was specifically designed to let the players be themselves.
And Randy, that oil pattern in your eyes coming in, does it favor anybody?
No, I think it's all predicated on how the players break the oil pattern down in practice, and then it's the adjustments that occurred during the matches. But I don't think it favors one player more than the next, no.
Close. Just crack open a six-pack.
And when we talk about adjustments, it's not just with feet and eyes in terms of where you're standing and looking on the lane. It's also with equipment. And that's exactly what Chris Barnes is doing, using two different bowling balls on this pair.
Barnes is mauling these lanes today. Dick Allen can max out at a 260, looking for his first pair of strikes and finds it.
Are you kidding me? How bad was that?
Randy Weiss, and here's Randy on the ride he's been on the last month.
Oh, this last month has been amazing. It has been so much fun. There's not even words to describe how fun, and I'd be lying if I didn't say how much I enjoyed all the attention I've been getting and all the excitement amongst all my people at home. It's been a great time.
Here is Weiss. Oof. Off target, he was saying to us yesterday, it's almost a shame that this month is about to end. It's been a great ride for him back in Columbia and through the PBA world as he continues his pursuit of his first ever PBA crown, but right of target there. So while he mulls that spare option, Chris Barnes steps up, looking to add the extra point to the touchdown.
Someone got it right in the middle. Oh, thank you.
Well, it looks like he just got too much hand in this shot here. Watch this ball just overreact and go right through the nose, leaving the 3-6-9-10.
Nice cleanup there by Weiss. And Weiss has been very solid with his spare work today, Randy.
Well, yeah, and that's what's kept him in this match, because his ball reaction does not look all that great right now. He finds himself in that number three spot. Remember, the low score is out. Right now, Randy Weiss trying to decipher what adjustments need to be made for him to continue on.
3-6-9-10 for Barnes. This is his first spare effort of the afternoon, and he drops those four pins.
Well, that's an important spare because Chris Barnes remains in the 240s with that conversion. The best Randy Weiss can shoot now, 237.
Allen in second. A strike would be huge. And he leaves the 10.
That's a better shot than last frame. Come on.
And if you're Randy Weiss, that's exactly what you wanted to see. Is you don't want Richie Allen to get too far out in front. This gives Richie Allen, or puts him in the high 200s as he leaves that ring in 10. Randy Weiss, all he needs is a double to get right back in this.
Weiss, his effort on the left lane.
Come on, Randy.
Oh, mighty.
1-2-4-10, washout.
Another washout.
That's the kind of shot you're going to make, huh?
A little hop there on the approach from Allen. Takes care of the 10
pin. Wait, Phil Frames. Golly.
Lucky ball choice.
Phil Frames, good advice.
Phil Frames, unfortunately for Randy Weiss, he's got to make back-to-back washouts on this left lane to stay in this.
First open frame of the afternoon.
Big trouble now. He's lost a lot of count the last three frames. So now for Randy Weiss, it's almost to that point where he's thinking, I've got to strike out to have any chance.
Cinderella's run may be coming to a close. Here's Barnes, who is in great shape as we begin the eighth.
Strike number seven. Now, the problem is for the player that advances, he gets to take on that beast of a man. And I mean beast of a man. This guy is making him look sick. Chris Barnes is in it to win it.
Finish. You could make a very strong case for Chris Barnes as player of the year. If you take away Mika Koivuniemi's unbelievable success at the majors, and it's hard to take that away because that's part of the season, Barnes is your player of the year. I think he's number two behind Mika.
Yeah, I'd go there.
And Neil number three.
I'd go there. But he's not going to pass Mika no matter what. If
absolutely
he
not
wins, Mika's season way too strong with all the majors and what he did at the majors. But, yeah, I mean, if for some reason, you know, Chris Barnes's road or tour roommate Mika Koivuniemi missed a couple of wake-up calls this season, Chris Barnes is your player of the year.
Easily. Big frame here for Weiss in the eighth.
Gotta have it.
And does.
He's got his third strike through eight.
Rob, he's got to have all of them to have any chance, in my opinion. Like Dick that. Allen is at 209. Randy Weiss can strike out for 212. That is if Dick Allen doesn't throw another double. The only chance Randy Weiss has, he must strike out from here on out. You're going to see a ball change coming up for Chris Barnes right now in that left lane. Some kind of adjustment. The last two shots going high. That one almost Brooklyn.
Allen working off a strike. Barnes. Spare.
Hey, Chris, the last two shots on the left lane both went high. What adjustments are you going to make on that left lane?
The first one was no good at all, Randy, but it was really slow. But that one there wasn't too bad. So the front's starting to break down for me. I either got to move about three left with that ball, or I start using the same ball on both lanes.
Thanks, Chris.
That conversation courtesy of PBA Talkback. Allen on the right lane. Filling frames. Another spare for Dick Allen.
Chris Barnes is locked into the finals now. The at very worst, he'll be in the 230s. The best Dick Allen can shoot 219. But for Randy Weiss, his tournament life is on the line. He must strike out ninth and tenth frame to have any chance.
Seeking his first double of the afternoon is Weiss.
Oh, yeah. Carry one.
And finds it.
Remember the last two shots on that left lane, he went washout, washout, finally comes back with a great shot when he needed it most.
Cinderella not yet ready to leave the dance floor.
Chris Barnes is locked, he's moving on right now. It's all about what happens here in the 10th frame for the 10th frame for Dick Allen. If he doubles and gets good count, he'll shut out Randy Weiss. There's one.
Barnes moves on. A two-match championship showdown. Waiting in the wings, will it be Dick Allen or will it be Randy Weiss that will be taking on Barnes? Allen with the advantage right now. Strike and four pins to advance. Leaves the 10.
Door is wide open for Randy Weiss.
Dick Allen's wife, Sarah, taking this one in. Randy Weiss taking the sweat off his brow. He's still alive. Barnes will conclude.
Give Dick Allen the spare here. He'll shoot 209. That means Randy Weiss will have to get two strikes in the 10th frame and eight to beat Dick Allen by one. Ten pin got swept off. Richie Allen not trying to ice Randy Weiss. He is simply waiting for that 10 pin to be respotted. Double and eight, Rob. Anything less, Dick Allen moves on, and Randy Weiss's Cinderella story comes to an end. Remember what he did against Tommy Jones. He needed all three to beat Tommy Jones by one pin. He got up and he went pack, 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 and sent Tommy Jones packing. Now he needs 2 and 8.
Oh, baby!
There's one.
Yeah. Well, you can see it when he threw it, man. He posted the shot up beautifully. That ball was dead flush. He needs one more just like it. Richie Allen bowled a really good game, had some unfortunate carry issues, which is the only reason why he only bowled 209. Now, Randy Weiss, one strike and eight pins away from taking on Chris Barnes for the title. Biggest shot of his career right here, Rob.
And Allen moves on. A game effort from Weiss. That'll be Dick Allen versus Chris Barnes for the Dick Weber playoff crown. And Cinderella has left the building. It's been a great run for Randy Weiss, and we really enjoy getting to know him and watching him roll. But his fellow Columbia, South Carolina native, Dick Allen, is just a little bit better. College bowling follows us next here on ESPN, and the college kids on the lanes will be in focus when our live coverage of the Dick Weber PBA playoff returns to Indy. Barnes versus Allen coming up.
Was that Chris Barnes?
Yeah, it's not pretty. Welcome you back to Indianapolis. Chris Barnes with the 245, Dick Allen with the 209. Those two move on, and lights out for Randy Weiss and his 200. Not enough to move on. Be sure to stay logged on to PBA.com in the upcoming months as your official source for all the latest PBA information, including news and results from the Senior Tour and some regional events. PBA Players and Rookie of the Year Awards will be announced first on PBA.com. And a little added bonus there, Extra Frame will be streaming live from some select Senior Tour events. You can get it all over there at PBA.com. Now, aside from his many PBA accolades, Chris Barnes, also a former Collegiate Bowler of the Year and a national champion at Wichita State. This next month is a big one for collegiate bowling, an area of the sport that just keeps on growing. College is a special time. Time to go out on your own, meet some new people, and perhaps experiment with some questionable style choices.
The mullet, the Clark Kent specs, it's obvious I need a few friends in college to kind of say, hey, that's not working for you.
A college bowler, though, is never short on friends. And it's that team atmosphere that makes the college game so rewarding and so terrifying.
It's the only time you can get happy for somebody else. Yeah, there's definitely a big anxiety factor when it comes to college bowling. I mean, you get up in the 10th frame and it goes bad. You turn around and you see those disappointed looks from everybody. It's not a good feeling.
It's exactly that pressure and experience that prepares an athlete for the next level.
Not very many people at 18 or 19 are ready to come out on tour, so the experience is so beneficial. I think that anybody that misses that end has a tough road.
I'd probably say the coaching prepped me the most. All the people that I bowled with, actually, I've still crossed paths with after college bowling, so that's helped a lot too.
Just take a look at today's tour, and you'll see a who's who of collegiate bowling's past, and there's little question that those players are building bowling's future.
It's nice because we're building through those programs of high school bowling to collegiate bowling, and then, you know, some of the guys are lucky enough to make it to Team USA, and there's a new era of players.
The Intercollegiate Team Championships will be streamed live on bowl.com, and the finals will air on ESPN2 on Sunday, May 15th, 2 Eastern. Chris Barnes will be part of that broadcast crew. And I never get tired, Randy, seeing Chris with the old hair and glasses. It's amazing he's married looking at that picture.
I think his entire teammates were donning the same do.
Maybe that's why no one is rejected. We have a flashback to 1961 David. And the beginning of our two-match championship showdown between Dick Allen and Chris Barnes when we return. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, welcome you back to Indianapolis. I feel like it's Johannesburg.
Do you?
Yeah, a little World Cup.
Minus the heat outside?
The threat of carjackings.
Yes, all of that with all the vuvuzelas out here.
It's wonderful. Time now for, oh man, look at that. That's Jay Led Bitter, the brother-in-law of Dick Allen, sporting a sweet stash just for today's show. It's a good-looking stash.
So wait a minute, he grew that just for today's show?
He did, and it's part of a wonderful segue for us today in our Just for Men mustache and beard keep your edge moment. And it features the upcoming 50th anniversary of the PBA Tour's first ever telecast. Next month on the 13th, the PBA will mark the 50th anniversary of the first telecast of the finals of a PBA tournament. It was the PBA National Invitational held in Paramus, New Jersey. And the success of that event led to the creation in 62 of the PBA's Pro Bowlers Tour Series on ABC TV. It's always fun to see see some of that black and white video from years gone by in the PBA. 50 years of television and the PBA together next month. Dick Allen with the 209, Chris Barnes with the 245. These two move on to the two-match championship showdown. It's interesting we say two matches because Chris Barnes, I think a lot of people through the years, oh, he's the best ball on the tour, he's the best ball on the tour, but there's a lot of times on TV in that one-match final where he doesn't show up. Now, if he doesn't show up, he's got another match to show up. And another solid start for Barnes.
And Rob, I think that's a huge advantage for Chris. He's such a tactical player. When given enough time, he figures him out, and then he just bombs him. And that's exactly what's going to happen today. He gets two games instead of one. They had a lot of practice in between the last match and this game here. And I've got to tell you, I think it's a huge advantage for Chris as you see Dick Allen making a ball change.
Drop and give me 10 for Allen. He'll admit to you, he's more of a field player. He's not technical to the degree that Barnes is, but that's how he likes to operate. And you can see it in his personality as well. That's just kind of the way Dick Allen rolls.
He started with a mission, and he went to a mission 250K, but I'm going to tell you right now, if Dick Allen were to win this tournament, nothing would mean more to him than beating Chris Barnes. I mean, he doesn't want to beat, you know, a guy that just walked off the street. He wants to beat this guy right here.
Dick told us yesterday he beat Barnes for a regional title about a decade ago, and he's mockingly telling us, I'm sure he's still stinging about that. I'm sure he remembers that. You know, but he's honest. He said he's my favorite bowler. It's so good. Man, how do you not want to bowl against that guy? And
that's good stuff.
That's classic Richie
yep.
/ Dick Allen right
well,
there.
It's funny because I had a conversation with Chris about that very story. I'll tell you about it in a second.
Here is Barnes. Strike in the first. Here's his effort in the second. He started off our first match with six straight strikes. And another great start.
So Chris brought that very same story up. He said, yeah, Richie Allen beat me for this regional title. For Richie, it was, you know, the greatest time of his life. For me, it was just a warm-up for the next tournament I was bowling.
Good times. Good times. Chris Barnes, this will be his eighth top 20 finish of the season and sixth in the top 10. Has the sixth highest average this season on the tour. And another strike. So Chris Barnes, sixth highest average on the tour this season. You expect that. You look through the numbers, you say, that sounds about right. Maybe even actually a little low for a guy like Chris Barnes. You look up, who's at number three? The guy in all white today, Dick Allen. Wow. A 10-pin shy of an opening triple for Allen.
And immediately the difference in ball reaction from what I see is that Richie's trying to go much straighter. Chris has already moved in and starting to create angle. And I think that's something that Richie will have to start thinking about in terms of pin carry if he has the same carry problems this game that he had last game.
Allen takes care of that one. NBA playoffs continue on ABC this afternoon. Game one of the Hornets-Lakers series as bowling fan Chris Paul leads New Orleans against the Lakers, who are looking for a third straight NBA title. You can see that one at 3:30. Coverage actually begins with the Buick Regal NBA countdown at 3 Eastern.
And Rob, just so you know, Andrew Bynum's knee, perfectly healthy for game one.
Oh, you talked to him today?
Or so I'm being told.
Oh, okay. Sources close to Randy Peterson. Yeah. That's Messenger nestles to the 10, can't drop it.
See how the ball's just pushing too long down the lane? For Richie, it's all about getting the ball into the lane a little bit sooner and cutting back on the ball speed. You see he's moved in a little bit, but now he's got to give it a chance to react. And all he needs to do is just get a little softer with the speed.
So looking for his second consecutive.
Look out.
Oh, boy.
Good balance there from Allen. We've seen a couple of footing issues from him already today.
That was athletic there. Watch this.
Clark needs to be fast.
Whoa. I'd have gone head first right in the middle of the lane.
That takes some core strength and some big-time balance because you've got a lot of energy and motion going towards that line to put on the brakes and hold it off. Barnes in the fourth.
How about a little hip on this Sunday?
This guy's on cruise control. Looks real comfortable. In complete control of what he's doing. Real solid. Richie Allen knows he's in a fight. Remember, this is not two-game total pinfall. It's just two games. If Chris Barnes were to win both games, obviously he would be your winner. If they split, we go to a sudden death one-ball roll-off. Richie Allen just needs to figure him out and stay close. Start striking and put some heat and pressure on Chris Barnes.
You know, Barnes, if he were to win today, would be the first player to win more than one title this season. If you go through the history, Randy, the PBA Tour, it has never happened that a player has not won multiple titles in a season. That even goes back to the first season of the tour in 1959. Barnes, an open frame. It goes back to 59 when there were only three events. Dick Weber won two of them. But here's a big gap from Barnes.
It's just hard to explain. I mean, it looks like he's on cruise control. He's throwing it great. All of a sudden, he gets a little quick with one shot and then whiffs a spare.
All right. Much better shot.
Not enough.
Best shot you've thrown today.
Back end entry angle into the pocket to carry the corner pins.
Only got about 40 minutes of bowling left. Let me count. Let's go.
He's got to somehow find a way, whether he tricks it up with his hand, speed, or he goes to a different bowling ball, to make the ball finish harder in the back part of the lane.
This will be his third straight 10-pin conversion for a spare should he drop it. And he does.
Nice approaches today. Nice.
Nice. Obviously not real excited about his footing and the approaches. A lot of times the approaches get affected by the humidity around the set.
You guys can blow them.
When the lights go up, the humidity sometimes tends to change, and that will affect synthetic approaches.
Me too. A little hard into it.
Also, you start cramming a bunch of bodies in this small arena.
Dick Allen in pursuit of his third career PBA title. A little stare down to Barnes. And Barnes has been staring everybody down today. The conclusion of match one between Allen and Barnes when we return. Welcome you back to ESPN's live coverage of the Lumber Liquidators. Dick Weber, PBA playoffs coming your way from Indianapolis, Indiana. Chris Barnes, Dick Allen battling. Great moment yesterday. That is 6-year-old David Richards Jr. suffers from leukemia, and courtesy of the Make-A-Wish Foundation, he was able to meet his idol and bowl with him, Chris Barnes, yesterday. I want to remind you, World Wish Day, April 29th. And just a great service that that foundation does for some of these young children across our country who have been put up against some difficult situations. And David, there he is in attendance live, getting a great applause here today. Good-looking young man. Met him yesterday. And talked to Chris Barnes about, you know, being the focus of a young kid's Make-A-Wish. And, you know, he said, it's pretty cool. When I was first told about it, I was speechless. And, you know, to think you could make an impression like that on a young man, incredibly humbling and a huge responsibility at the same time.
Go, 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 go.
We got the go, go, go to go.
Yeah, he's got a good touch going at the bottom of the swing, and that ball got a little wide of target, but he had enough stuff on it to get it to Reed and get back to the 1-3.
Take a look at some of the other finishers here in Indianapolis. The man who came in fourth, our good friend, the Ripper, Jack Jurek. Jarris there in fifth. Jason Belmonte lost to that man, Chris Barnes. He finished in sixth. TJ, Tommy Jones in seventh. And a little legend, Walter Ray, Wayne Jr. Yes. Eighth, and another strike for Barnes.
Rebounded nicely from the open frame in the fifth.
David likes it.
Son Ryan likes it.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy, that 10 pin.
Oh, no.
Really causing Allen some problems here in match one.
Yeah, it's been all about carry for Dick Allen today. Somehow I just can't seem to get Richie out of my head because, number one, it's on the back of his shirt. But it's been all about carry and carry issues for him. 10 pin, 10 pin, 10 pin, 10. Four 10 pins in seven frames. You're not going to beat anybody leaving 10 pins four, five, six times a game. It's just not going to happen, especially against a guy like Chris Barnes, who's locked in. He's able to string strikes. Richie started with a double, then it was 3-9 spares, a strike in the sixth, and then another ring in 10.
Good thing, though, for Allen. Still a manageable deficit, A. And number B, he has another match to try and get back this in. Did I say number B?
That's what you said, number B.
Yeah,
I like that.
I gotta get back to the books. There we go. Back on the strike train is Dick Allen.
All right. Much better bar action.
Last couple shows, Allen was wearing the all black. He's like, man, everybody's going to be rooting against me. Everybody likes Barnes. Everybody likes the story about Randy Weiss trying to win his first title. How about me? I'm going to put on the white hat, be the good cowboy, and see if I can get some fans in here. And he's doing that, but Barnes, there it is.
Remember the last shot on that lane, Rob? Got it wide, came back and kind of tickled the rack. This time he throws a pretty good shot, checks early, goes right through the face, leaving a big four.
It's only been completed one time on television. Walter Ray Williams Jr. did it in 2005. Yeah, the look of surprise and then the look of, oh boy, what do I got to do here?
He may have just lost this match because of that one shot.
This could be his second open frame of this match. Could be and will be.
And the bigger issue, he's got to finish on that lane in the 10th frame, and right now he doesn't have a clue as to what his ball's going to do on that lane.
It's amazing in this sport how you can go from just being absolutely in control, nobody's going to get in your way, and then, like that, it U-turns on you.
It's the invisible demon that's applied to the lane surface that nobody can see.
Leaves the 10 pin.
Another ring and 10 on the left lane for Chris Barnes. With a spare here, he can strike out in the 10th frame for just 218 now. Richie Allen can strike out for 237. And just when it looked like this is going to be a rout, Richie Allen is right back in it. Look at that grin, like he just came out of the chicken coop with a couple of prize hens. Huh?
Little sly dog.
Approach. There's his first lead.
And Allen pointing to a spot on the approach. Sticking has been an issue for him all afternoon. There it is. There's that big balance issue in the fourth frame.
That was on the left lane.
And here on the right.
Oh, no.
But a wild release of that follow-through leg. Now he moves back to the left lane.
One strike, six pins away from shutting out Barnes, Rob.
There's your strike.
Ooh, I guarantee just one shot for the guy. Just one.
I wish he'd give us a sign that he's excited. The Vizalas are out. This young man has just dominated this tournament. Six pins, and he will wrap up match number one versus Barnes.
There's six and then some. One win away from tour title number three for Dick Allen.
We thought he was out of this one. Barnes opened the door for him with an open frame in the fifth and the eighth.
Not really sure what that was.
That was a look-away strike.
No, did you threw it off his right leg?
Just dropped it, rolled it, walk away,
get all 10 to go.
That's Dick Allen for you, baby.
How about them? How about them apples?
When we return, we visually reflect back on what may go down as one of the more memorable seasons in PBA history. We just saw a memorable shot from Dick Allen.
This tournament named in honor of Dick Weber, who was voted the third greatest player in PBA history a few years ago, won 30 PBA Tour titles, seventh all-time, and also claimed six senior tour titles, inducted into the PBA Hall of Fame in 75, the USBC Hall of Fame in 71, PBA titles in six different decades. That's the stat that always seems to jump out to me. And, of course, he and his son, Pete, the only father-son tandem in the PBA Hall of Fame for now until your son gets his way in there, Randy.
Thanks, Rob. Also, did you mention Dick Weber, born in Indianapolis? But the thing I remember most about Dick Weber, obviously we talk about what a great ambassador he was to the sport and what a great guy he was. Absolutely all true. But on the lanes, one of the most fierce competitors you ever came across. This guy would just as soon rip your heart out than to shake your hand. Fierce, awesome competitor on the lanes, complete gentleman off.
Just an awesome guy to be associated with if you were the PBA. Our thanks to Jim Doty, the general manager here at Royal Pin Leisure Centers. Woodland Bowl is one of the four bowling centers in the Royal Pin chain. There's Carmen Salvino right next to him. Carmen and his lovely wife in attendance. Carmen shared sushi with my wife, Lynn, in Reno earlier this season. And I am convinced that if Carmen and my wife were allowed to have dinner together, I would no longer be married.
Good call.
Yeah.
He's pretty smooth.
Very. Heavy on that one, and what a horrible start for Allen.
The good news for Richie Allen is that
started worse.
The worst thing that could happen is he goes to sudden death.
So an open frame for Dick Allen and an early opening for Chris Barnes. And Chris, you've had some time to think about that first match. What were some of the thoughts that were going through your head?
Well, it all kind of started off. I got a little too cute with the 4-8, trying not to chop it and miss that. But the one that got me was the right lane. And I missed a little move there, and I hooked early in a big forward. And so I'm going to switch balls on this right lane. I'm going to use the same world beater on the right lane I'm using on the left lane.
So there's Chris Barnes and his strategy. in a must-win match for Chris Barnes. He wins this, we go to a one-ball roll-off for the title. Open frame for Allen. Here's Barnes with his opening shot of the second match. And again, like we've seen all afternoon here in India, another solid start.
And if we do go to the one-ball roll-off, Chris Barnes is the higher seed. He would get choice of starting lane and position.
Allen in his Sunday whites.
It's Wimbledon-like, isn't it, Rob? With Richie? I love it. It's got a good blueprint now. A lot of practice in between the last game and the start of this game. Made the adjustments necessary, changed bowling balls. Perfect start for Chris Barnes. Richie Allen down 21 after two.
10?
Yeah!
Needed that. Just kind of mentally needed that with all the issues he had despite winning match one, but with that 10 pin.
Watch this here. The 6 pin's going to go to the sidewall and just give the 10 a little love tap.
Just enough to knock it off balance. It's really hard not to enjoy watching this young man bowl.
Yeah, he's quite the character.
Back-to-back jacks.
There you go. I really like what he's done with his game and the changes that he's made and trying to get the ball onto the lane a little bit cleaner. He's really reduced the amount of loft. Don't get me wrong, he can still do that when he needs to, but I think it's really taken his game to the next level. Well, you heard him say it, a little firm, and that kept the ball from finishing stronger in the back part of the lane. Big thing that Chris Barnes has been working on is not tipping early in the first couple of steps, in between two and three especially. That's what he keys on Sundays when he's doing his thing.
No better time to fire up the RV than during the summer.
Without question.
PBA Summer Series begins Saturday, June 25th. Looking forward to that event.
I'll bring the burgers and dogs. You get the charcoal.
I'll bring the condiments.
Okay. Boy, and this is the internal battle that us players have. He starts off two perfect strikes and then goes shaker 7, weak 10. After all that practice, he had immediate confirmation in the first two frames as to the choice that he made, and now all of a sudden, the second guessing starts. Are you with me?
That's a big mind game.
It's like bang, bang, and then all of a sudden, wait a minute, what, huh? What happened?
Changed, right. So Allen steps up in the fourth, open frame in the first, strike in the second, and another strike in the third.
A little Hannibal Lecter look going to the foul line.
And again, a 10-pin issue.
It's a little bit tight. He's a little bit tight.
Boy, he was looking for something to open up the can of fava beans, taking out Chris Barnes' liver and having a go. With a strike there, he would have been in great position and would have taken the lead. Now, just 10 back. Thank you.
Big discrepancy between the two lanes as far as strike success rate for Allen this afternoon.
Yeah, not so good on the right lane.
He'll finish on the right. Here he is on the left.
Look out.
Big four. Not big trouble.
Not deep enough on that lane. What a seesaw match already. We're only five frames into it. Goes through the nose early in the first frame. Comes back, throws a perfect shot, and goes strike. This shot here cuts right through the heart again. Big four. Counted as an open frame. This has only been made once in the history of television.
So both players now have had a duel of big four, and both go left, both walk away with an open frame. Barnes did it in match one, Allen here in match number two. Here's the left-right lane comparison for Barnes. A little more success on the right, which is where he is right now.
He has to finish on the left. Okay, got into that shaker zone there, Rob, and switched him around a bit. Son Ryan flexing his muscles. So come on, man, throw some strikes, man.
And off in the distance, Allen kind of turned away and fanned his hand.
Big thing for Richie Allen right now is the left lane.
Barnes on that left lane now. And looks like a ball change here for Barnes.
Oh, no.
7-10.
Chris Barnes talked to us about this very issue. Watch the left lane. Pocket 7-10 splits throughout. These Dick Weber playoffs have plagued players, but only this left lane. Moves in, throws a great shot here. You see the ball laboring just to get to the 1-3, and then all of a sudden, pocket 7-10. Talk about seesaw back and forth.
7-10 on television has not been taken care of since 1991. So, pair of matching open frames now for Allen and Barnes, and it was about at this juncture in match number one where we were saying, boy, Barnes is in cruise control, but there's Allen just, you know, 14, 16, 18 pins back. He's in good position here.
Less pressure for Dick Allen.
Strike number three for Dick.
He still has sudden death guaranteed.
Right.
Chris Barnes has to win.
Saw Dick's wife there cheering her man on. One shot roll off to determine the champion should Barnes win this match.
14 pin deficit for Dick Allen. He can cut it to four with a strike right here. That's light. This is in that mixer zone there, but he wasn't going to go through the nose again. Four pins, Rob.
And now let's see how Barnes reacts after that open frame in the sixth. He moves from the left to the right lane. Two of his three strikes of this match have come on that right lane. Again. Back to back 7-10s left by one of the game's greats.
And Rob, in my 30 years of being involved with the PBA, whether it was on tour bowling or doing broadcasting, I can't remember the last time a player's left back to back 7-10s, especially given the circumstances.
Wow. Did this match just turn?
Yeah, and it turned real ugly for Chris Barnes. Just unbelievable back-to-back horrible breaks. Now he's down by seven. It was just a couple of frames ago where he was up
14.
He was up by 24 and now finds himself behind. He can strike out to shoot 215. It's the best he can do. Dick Allen can shoot 232.
Barnes asks for a re-rack. If you were his coach, if you were in his ear right now, what would you be telling him?
I'd tell him to soften it up just a pinch. But right now, the big thing for him is mentally he's got to regroup because he just got punched in the gut twice really, really hard. He's got to shake it off and somehow find it within himself to come back and make great shots here in the 8th, 9th, and 10th frame.
And he can do it.
Yes, he can.
And there you go. He's back.
Yeah, and I'm going to say he's not real happy right now because Chris Barnes knows that those two 7-10 splits in between the two strikes could very well cost him this tournament. Let's see if Richie can get the corner pin out here on the right lane.
Looking for three strikes in a row. Sarah watching, cheering him on. His newborn daughter, Piper, is just a little bit offset, being tended to by a family friend. And he is a different man since he became a dad. Allen can max out at 232. Barnes now, the best he can do, a 215.
Approaches all day. Watch this.
So
look at how he comes up on that toe, almost fouls, puts his hands on his head, and just shreds the rack. Chris Barnes in the same lane with pocket 7-10 on a great shot. Sometimes when things go your way, it just doesn't matter. Right now, looking like this is all about Dick Allen.
And this is a tournament that just about the entire field will tell you he has dominated from the outset. Chris Barnes just utilizing his final re-rack. Two frames left for him. He has just got to strike and strike and strike.
This ball looked like it was never going to get there and just trips the 2-8 out late. But quite honestly, after the 2-7-10 splits, he deserves a little break there, and he just got it. Now, like you said, Rob, the only chance is striking out 215. If he does get a double and 8, it would force Dick Allen to get the first strike in the 10th. We've seen it happen time and time again this season. When players look like they were left for dead, they strike out in the 10th frame, their opponent gets up, and there's a colossal blunder.
Leaves the 10.
You got it!
Tough for Ryan to watch this one. And the other side of the story, Dick Allen on the verge of a win here.
For
despair, but for all intents and purposes.
For all intents and purposes, Richie Allen just needs to show up in the 10th frame. The best Chris Barnes is going to shoot is 194. Richie Allen needs to keep it on the lane. He's going to win his third title. But just, again, the back-to-back pocket 7-10s absolutely killed Chris Barnes and any chance he had to win this.
Leaves the 10.
Sorry,
well, it's looking like for the first time in PBA history, there will be no two-time winner in a season campaign. Dick Allen is up. He was telling me a story when he was a 17 or an 18-year-old down in Meridian, Mississippi.
Camera, please.
If you won the tournament, you would get your name on the flyer next year as the defending champ. He said, that's what I want. I don't need the check. I want my name on that flyer. 8 pins for the win. Give it to him. He deserved this moment. A huge
baby monkey, baby,
epic effort.
Baby monkey, that's for you, Rob.
From Dick Allen.
Oh, I love this guy. We'll talk to him when we return.
Congratulations, great.
This is the scene just a few moments ago.
Thanks, Carmen.
Legend Carmen Salvino handing the hardware off.
That's what it's all about right here. Sometimes the villain dresses in white.
It's hard to categorize Dick Allen as a villain. There are a lot of people out there who like him, and they're going to like him a lot more with what he did today. A big win here in match number 2 versus Chris Barnes, 221 to 193. Time now for our Geico Championship recap. It began with the three-way showdown between Chris Barnes, Dick Allen, and Randy Weiss. Chris Barnes just ran away from the field, dropped to 245, so it became a battle between Allen and Weiss. Who would have the higher score to move on? And it was Allen by 9 over Weiss. So, game number 1 of our championship showdown here. And again, another great start for Chris Barnes, opening ham bone, and then Rutrow, big 4. He left in the 8th, an open frame there. Dick Allen, kind of filling frames, getting strikes, getting 9 spares, finished strong, dropped to 237. He was 1 win away from the title. Game number 2, Allen. Big strike there. After Barnes left the door open after dropping back-to-back 7-10 splits. And Chris Barnes, ever the sportsman. That's David Richards Jr., the young man from the Make-A-Wish Foundation, whose wish was to meet Chris Barnes. He was here all weekend. He got to meet Barnes, got to watch him bowl for the title. Unfortunately, he got to see him lose. Randy, standing by, though, with our winner, the incomparable Dick Allen.
Thanks, Rob. A little hard to hear here with all the horns. Richie, you dominated this tournament from start to finish, so it's only fitting that you come away with this victory. But you're a new dad now. The family's gotten a little bit bigger. Describe what this win means to you and your family.
Everything. Period. Everything.
All right. Well, with that being said, first shot, you got 1 win under your belt. You need 1 more game to capture this. You start out with a big split. What went through your mind then?
Lane broke down a little bit. I felt like I was grabbing it. I just went ahead and made a ball change. You know, Abinett makes the best stuff in the world. Mission 250K, the ball's really, really good. Go get you one. I made the move, and it looked really, really good. And that was the plan all along. I just had to get deep enough, and I knew nobody could compete with me.
What about when Chris Barnes went back-to-back solid 7-10s?
I hate to say that I loved it, but I loved it. And, that was the opening I needed, and I stepped in and I took advantage of it. That's what you're supposed to do as a professional.
And you did that brilliantly. Congratulations.
Thanks, Vice. Thanks, Abinett.
Great show throughout the course of this tournament for Dick Allen. A big win versus one of the game's best in Chris Barnes. Tour title number 3 for Dick Allen, and that'll put a wrap and put a bow on one of the more memorable seasons in PBA history. 52 seasons in the book for Randy Peterson and our entire crew on Rob Stone. Thank you guys and gals back there for a wonderful year. You guys do magical work, and it is noticed. More bowling coming your way. NCAA Bowling Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car from outside Detroit is next. Dick Allen is your winner.